cookie swirl. See?
Aw, look at how sweet. Punk boy as a tiny Barbie baby.
Wait a minute, Cookie Fans. That's not Punk Boy as a baby. Oh, I know what we're gonna be doing today. We're gonna be taking this super duper cute little Barbie baby and we're gonna be turning it into Punk Boy.
Yep, that's me.
So here we have LOL doll Punk Boy. Now, of course, we know what he looks like. Woo! As Lil Punk Boy. Here's his little brother. But I wanna see what he looks like as this adorable little Barbie baby.
I'm gonna be really, really cute.
So the first thing that we're gonna do to transform this Barbie baby into Punk Boy, we're gonna give him a little mini mohawk. So we're gonna create one that's a lot smaller than Lil Punk Boy. So I'm just gonna be using some of my air dry clay. Just gonna use a teeny tiny little pinch, not too much. And now on my little Barbie baby, I'm just going to take my clay and I'm just going to place it on his head. And I wanna make sure I go all the way down to the very end of his hairline and maybe even a little bit over. So I'm gonna roll out my clay and now place it on right down the middle of his head. Now this is a little double baby that I had. I love these little Barbie babies. I think these are so cute. So there we go. Once I kind of get the basic shape of what I want, I'm just gonna use a little bit of some water, put my hands in here and just press this hair onto him. Ooh, and make it stick and kind of blend in with his hair color. Looks like he kind of has like a little bit of like a mullet. Press that hair down, press, press, press. And then we can clip it right here with my nail and just kind of cut it off. There we go. Now that I have his hair molded on, he looks kind of silly like this. I'm going to now take my toothpick and I'm going to create the same kind of lines here, just like we have on Lil Punk Boy. And I'm just going to pinch my clay a little bit to kind of make it stand up again. Because again, he's like a newborn little baby, so I don't want to do too much. And I just want to create these little lines on both sides of his hair and kind of push my clay into his hair a little bit too to create those little mohawk ridges.
Ooh, the hardest thing for me is keeping it straight.
Press in, create that little ridge. Now the front piece of his hair will just kind of pull down like that and kind of push it down and pinch. And now for the little front piece here, I'm just gonna kind of move it around a little bit and just kind of shape it and sculpt it just however I think it should possibly look. There's no wrong way. You can do it any way you'd like. And then I'm just gonna kind of go in and just kind of clean up his hair here. It's not quite centered, so I'm just gonna kind of push it over just a little bit. Want it to be as centered as much as I possibly can, but I think it looks pretty good. Now I'm gonna go in and try to create just a few more of these little tiny little lines. So again, with my toothpick, just gonna just push the clay in. Create little lines.
All right, I think his little mini mohawk looks really, really good.
So now I'm just gonna let this air dry. All right, so little baby Punk Boy's had plenty of time to dry. So now his hair is, oh no, I moved his hair. Oh no, and it's starting to slide around a little bit. Okay, it's okay, it's okay. We can fix that easily.
Let's go ahead and add some Mod Podge on and just really make sure his hair stays nice and firm to his head. I had to be really careful because I do not want his hair to break.
So I can't really remove it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my Mod Podge, which is basically just like a glue and a sealer. And I'm just gonna hold his mohawk in place and I'm just going to Mod Podge the edges.
Whoa, I cannot believe that happened.
There we go, just Mod Podge the edges.
Nobody will know.
And this should keep it now still and glue it to his head basically. Just go around all the edges.
Woo,
there we go. And I'll just wipe away some of the extra Mod Podge that got on his forehead since it is kind of like a glue. Here we go.
Okay, let's try that again.
Let this dry. Now, while we wait for his hair to dry, now let's go ahead and paint in his eyebrows. So you can see, whoa, the color changed. Whoa,
his hair totally changed color.
So you can see that Punk Boy and his little brother have lighter color eyebrows. So they're kind of like an orangey brown. And they actually kind of match his lip color too. I'm gonna take some of this tan color.
Ooh, it's called cinnamon.
And I'm gonna mix it with a touch of this spiced carrot color. I'm gonna take a little bit of this paint, mix up my two colors to get the perfect color, put a little bit on my toothpick. Now I'll just carefully recolor his eyebrows. And same thing with his lip color. So we're just kind of gonna color his lips in. So now they're no longer pink, they're kind of this carroty brown color. Now I wasn't going to paint this Barbie baby's eyes, but since Punk Boy has such beautiful, rich, dark, dark brown eyes, I say let's just go for it. So I've got this chocolate sprinkle color. Now very, very ever so carefully with my toothpick, I'm going to paint his eyes in and just make them just a teeny tiny touch darker. Now, of course, for something like this, I want to take my time because this is very, very, very delicate. I got a really small area to work with. Just kind of darken that color up. There we go. There's one eye. I mean, it's a very, very teeny tiny subtle difference, but this eye is much darker. Do the same thing with the other eye. Eyes are darkened. Now, while we wait for all that to dry, we're gonna start coloring in his diaper. So just like Lil Punk Boy, he's like a light gray color. So I'm going to take this pewter gray and I'm gonna use a flat tip brush and I'm gonna take just a little bit of this pewter gray color here. I mean, just a little bit, like right on the tip here like that. Dip it in some water and then now I'm just going to put it here on my little wax paper and I'm just gonna keep adding in more and more water to this. So basically it's just gonna become really, really a watered down gray color, just like that. So it's super duper watered down. And now I'm just going to paint this on over the white. Here we go, because I still want it to be really, really, really movable still, because if I just started painting this cloth diaper, it could become really, really stiff whenever it dries, and I don't want to do that. I want to keep it nice and soft still. So basically, I'm just coloring the fabric, just painting it on with gray water. There we go. Now that color is all watered down and painted on here, and now I'm just gonna let this dry. There we go. Now his diaper is all dry. Now it's this gray color that matches Lil Punk Boy perfectly. Now we're gonna start coloring in his hair. So I think I found the perfect mohawk color. This is Tuscan Teal. Check it out. Ooh, that's a perfect match. Look at that color. So now I'm just going to color in his mohawk. And of course, I can't forget to do the other side of his hair. Then I'll switch over to a thinner brush, and now I can paint the details that are kind of in the front of his hair here. Now to create the second color of his hair really kind of varies, of course, because he is a color-changing LOL doll. So I wanna kind of get in between these two colors here. It's kind of like a purpley blue. So I'm just gonna take some of my lavender that I have. So let's see if I can mix up a color that I like. Let's see, I'm gonna take purple, and we'll mix it in with some of this bright blue and mix those two colors together. And what do we get? Ooh, that's kind of a nice color. Let's add some more purple in, kind of a darker purple, maybe a little bit more blue. There we go. I think that's a pretty good punk boy hair color. Now I'm gonna take this custom mix color and just paint it right on him. And of course, I like some of these little baby hairs that they have on these little dolls, so I'll just kind of repaint over them. He's looking so, so cute. Something I do want to add in to cute little punk boy baby is add his little cheetah print to his hair. I think that's a really cool feature that he has. So of course, I'm gonna use a toothpick and some of my black paint, and I'm just gonna go in and just create all of these like little tiny details and squiggles and little animal print lines in his hair. There we go, so there's one side of him. Turn him around, and the other side. There we go, now he has all of his hair painted on. So he's looking pretty good. Now I'm not gonna add in the freckles that Punk Boy has, because you can't see them whenever he's like a little toddler baby here. So I think it's time to seal everything on in. So I'm gonna be using two different types of varnishes. I've got an ultra matte for his hair and a satin for his eyes. So everywhere I painted, I'm just going to put my little varnish on and this will protect the paint. All right, little baby Punk Boy, where are you? Let's roll him on in. Aw, what a sweetie. Ah, you guys, he's so cute. So that he looks so adorable as a little itty bitty Barbie baby. So we'll take him right out of his little baby carrier. Aw, look at that, you guys. He totally turned out. I think it looks just like him. He's so cute. Check out that wild, wild hair that he has. Looks really, really good. So here I made him just have a tiny little itty bitty baby mohawk. So it's just kind of subtle, but that animal print hair is completely wild, just like Punk Boy. So of course I darkened his eyes and then I gave him that gray diaper as well. And I think it looks very, very similar to him. It looks totally just like him. Aww, that was totally cute as a baby. I hope you guys Cookie fans enjoyed this video of turning this Barbie baby into an LOL surprise punk boy. If you guys like to see me create more LOL as Barbie babies, let me know in the comments. Have the best day ever, and I will see you guys, boom, ba-doom, boom, on over to my next video. Bye, Cookie fans! Alright, Cookie fans, who remembers? What color did I mix with the purple to create Punk Boy's perfect hair color? Did I mix purple and red, purple and green, purple and orange, or purple and blue together? Bye, Cookie fans!